Since we're in the middle of talking about security, this would be a good time to bring up something we've discussed in some other videos. The video is called Pi Trusts. Also, the videos on those long sequence on interface installation and configuration. We mention that there's a special way you need to really treat trusts for interfaces. We suggest that trusts for interfaces be configured such that they are associated with an identity, like this one right here, that has permission only to write to the tags, you know, of that are collected by that interface. Now, that is as opposed to a practice that used to be very common, and we even used to recommend sometimes, and that was the practice to associate these trusts with piadmin. Now, as you've seen in our discussions of security, we really do not recommend you associate things with piadmin. You know, here's a trust, for example, that allows perfmon interface to run remotely, connecting as piadmin. Well, that's not a real good idea. I mean, technically, some joker could sit down, write a little Windows application that uses that as its process name, and as long as he can install it somehow and run it from this machine, then he's going to have full access to Pi. And of course, that's not a good scenario. What we suggest instead of giving people full access through piadmin, instead, when configuring these trusts, you configure them to connect using an identity that only has limited permissions, like this one right here. So you create your own identity and have that associated specifically with that trust that's associated with the interface. And that would go for all of the different trusts that are required for that interface. So if you've got an older interface that uses both the API and the SDK, we would suggest two trusts, you know, one for each API and one for SDK, both mapping to that same identity. And then also for any of the other programs that are running on that machine, for example, if buffering is running on that remote node, set up a trust that uses, again, that same identity so that you're only giving permission to write to the tags that need to be written to by that computer. Now, when you create these trusts, just make sure you create these trusts that are in a way that's restricted. In other words, it's not a bad idea to restrict it both to the name of the application and the IP address. It's much, much better than a liberal trust that simply, for example, requires something like this. That would allow any application, regardless of the name, coming from that computer to have the permissions of this identity. That's not a good thing. No, it would be better to specify more than one criteria. And that would go for any of the trusts that are running on here. Yeah, make sure that you specify both either the IP or the network path and the application name. And one last point, and I'd like to demonstrate this with an example, is that you may have some trusts that we haven't discussed so far anywhere else in this class. And that would be a trust that's required for things like interface configuration utility running on that remote machine. See, the interface configuration utility running on a remote machine, let me show you this again, on our remote machine here, it has to run on a remote machine because that's where the interface files are stored. I go into interface configuration utility here. Yeah, there we go. But see, the first thing that ICU application does is it goes out and it reads from the Pi server, it reads the list of interfaces that are stored in the module database. That's actually where we keep the interface information for right now. So that information is being read from the module database. Well, if you make configuration changes, you're going to need to write back to the module database. So that means that you're probably going to need, well, you will, you'll need a trust that grants this ICU application permission to write to the module database. Now, let me describe how you would do this. You would do it the same way as we've done these other trusts. You would configure a trust in which you would make reference to an identity, not piadmin. Again, that's sometimes the way people handle this. Sometimes they'll just put piadmin in there. But you want to use an identity that only has permission to write to the module database, and that's all. So we name this by IP address. We name it by its executable, PyICU. That's the name of the executable for interface configuration utility. And then we associate that with this 4ICU. Now, what does 4ICU get to do? If we take a look at this identity, 4ICU. Well, first of all, it's going to have to be associated with some kind of a Windows user, so it does have to be mapped to a user. That's a requirement in order to write to the module database. Just point that out in passing. But what 4ICU, the identity, is going to be able to do is it's going to have permission to write to the module database. So I need to go in here and add 4ICU as an identity that has permission to write. Now, because that 4ICU identity is actually mapped to an identity and defined in a trust, then it will get to pick up the permissions of PyWorld. You know, anything that maps correctly through a trust or through an identity to the Py server will get the same privileges as PyWorld. So what you'll notice when we actually try this is even though he doesn't have permission to write, he does have permission to read. So that's why when I launched ICU earlier, it was able to go out and read. But if you'll notice, if I go to try to change any of these things, I can't change them. I cannot make any changes to any of this because it's basically locked because it's in read-only mode. So let me close out of this. Let me go back to my server, and let's actually give this the permission it needs under PyModules. I will add 4ICU, and I will give that 4ICU, I will give that read-write access. Now let me go ahead and go back, log into ICU again, or log in using ICU. And this time with read-write access, we should have permission to read. And then once we read this in here, now we should have permission to write back. So if I need to go in and change this timeout, as you can see, now I can go ahead and make those changes. So that's the demonstration of basically what you're going to require if you have these other trusts for things like ICU or PySMT run remotely. You know, just make sure that when you create those trusts, you don't simply just default those trusts over to you don't want to have those default to piadmin. You'd like them to go to a user that's been defined or an identity that's been defined with only the minimum permissions required.